Hi. So you may be wondering what this giant stack of books is right here. These are all books that I'm unhauling, and I'm going to show them to you today. It's going to be a great day, and then hopefully I can get these out of here because the stack is humongous. There's 43, something like that, books in here. I don't even know. Hi, editing Sara. There's 38 books. There were 43. I took 5 out for a different video. I tried filming this video a week ago and didn't record with any sound and I cried and we're just gonna move on and we're gonna do it now. So yay! A lot of these are not books that I dislike. Some of them are. Most of them though are just books that I enjoyed in the past and don't really want on my shelf because I just reorganized my shelf and I'm still in the process of reorganizing my shelf and I didn't need them anymore. So yeah. Okay, the first book I'm gonna be unhauling is Lord of the Flies by, what is it, William Golding? William Golding. I don't like this book. I had to read it in freshman year of high school. I really hated it. Lord of the Flies is about a group of boys that get stranded on an island and starts basically killing each other, and it's a metaphor for like barbarianism and like war. There's just so much description that I don't need. I think the concept is interesting. I think it's weird, but I vibe with weird stuff, so I'm fine with the concept. The book, the writing, no thank you. So I will not be keeping this. I have no desire to keep this. I have no desire to ever read this book ever again. The next two books I'm unhauling kind of go together, and that's Milk and Honey and The Sun and Her Flowers by Rupi Kaur. They're both poetry books. These aren't bad. I just don't really have a place for them on my shelf and I don't pick them up and reread them enough to want to keep them on my shelf. So they're pretty, they're cool. As you can see, they have a lot of post-it notes in them because I use quotes for this for some projects that I worked on for school. But other than that, I don't really need them, so they're getting unhauled. This next book I DNF, I don't even know how long ago. This book is Juba by Walter Dean Myers. I remember I read like the first 100 pages, did not like it. I don't even remember what it's about. I think it's about an African-American boy who's like a dancer in the 20s. Apparently it's a true story. I just didn't really like it when I read it. I didn't hate it. I just never finished it. No tea, no shade, just facts. The next book I'm gonna be unhauling is Mia Earle and the Dying Girl by Jesse Andrews. This was actually a book I really enjoyed and I was gonna reread it this year, but I was going through my shelf and I just decided that I probably wasn't ever gonna get around to it. Mia Earle and the Dying Girl is about this girl named Rachel, I think, and this kid and his friend Earl, and they meet this girl. She has some sort of cancer sickness thing and they become friends, and it's not a romance, which is why it was good, and it's just funny and quirky and weird. I watched the movie. I liked the movie. I thought the book was really good. Again, just not something I wanted on my shelf and not something I think I'm gonna reread, so I don't really see a point in keeping it. All right, next is the Vampire Academy series. There's 6 of them. Basically, I really loved these when I read them. Don't think I'm ever gonna reread them. If I read one more book that has an academy in it, I'm gonna scream. Like, I just can't. I can't. Why does every place need a special school to train the vampires? They don't even get trained for anything. They're just go to school, but at night, like, well, I don't know. Vampire Academy, pretty obvious by the title. It's about an academy of vampires. These books were good. I'm just never gonna read them again. And to be honest, the titles are really cringy and I didn't want them on my shelf anymore. Oh, the mailman's here. I see him. Along with the Vampire Academy series, I'm gonna be unhauling the Bloodline series. This is the spinoff and it's actually better. Well, it was better. I really enjoyed these and I really planned on finishing reading them until I read this one. One of the most frustrating books I've ever read in my entire life. I had so many problems with it. I was just done after this. I was just done. And I never came back to them, so I don't care anymore. I will always have fond memories of Adrian What's-His-Face from this series, but other than that, goodbye. Next, I'm gonna be unhauling If I Stay by Gail Forman. This book, I'm pretty sure, is about a girl who gets into a car crash and is in a coma, and she has to, like, choose between if she wants to die or she wants to keep living. I'm just not gonna read it again. Like, this is just one of those, like, 2013 books that I was just really into at the time, don't care about anymore, so goodbye. Okay, next, I think I'm gonna get some hate for this. Okay, it's kind of a funny story by Nevazzini. I didn't love this when I first read it, and I don't think I ever will. People really, really love Nevazzini. Martini and his book, and I totally get it. They're just not for me. I thought I was gonna like this. I really thought I was gonna like this, and there were some elements that I did like. I just didn't really connect to it in the way that I thought I was going to because it was so hyped up. So I'm gonna be unhauling this one. Next is The Uglies by Scott Westerfeld. This is a trilogy, but there is like one, I don't know if it's like a spinoff or continuation or what. There's a fourth book. I don't even know where it went. I read it. I didn't like it. This series is basically about this future dystopian society where you, when you turn 16, have this plastic surgery done to you where you become a pretty. Before that, you're an ugly, and the pretties are like the top people in society, and they're the wealthy, and they just have a fun life doing whatever, and the uglies basically work for all them. The concept is cool. The books made me more and more frustrated as I went on. The books are cool. They're just like not books I want anymore. I read them. That's it. I'm not gonna be rereading them. Next, we have 13 Reasons Why by Jay Asher. I really enjoyed this book when I first read it. I've actually read it twice. I read it once, and then I read it again once before the TV show came out. I don't want to keep it anymore. But to be honest, after I watched the end of season 2 of the TV show, I was done. Didn't watch the third season. The whole second season was like not it, but like that last episode, I was done. Like that was not, no, absolutely not. So yeah, never again. And yep, I have the Maze Runner series by James Dashner. I liked the first book. The other two I remember not liking. I thought the plot was so cool, and I think that's probably why I liked them. These teens get put in this maze that is like trying to kill them. I don't even remember what else happens. I just remember getting so frustrated with the last two books. I don't even know. These just turn into a hot mess at the end, and I have a special place in my heart for these books because I loved The Maze Runner so much, but yeah, it's just not, it's just, it turned into something that I didn't like, and yeah, I just don't care anymore. Next we got A Work in Progress by Connor Franta, and Justine on YouTube. I don't know how to pronounce her name. Izaric, Justine Izaric. I came to own these because one time when I went to BookCon in like 2015, they were there and they were selling signed copies of their books. My friend was like obsessed with them. I got these, I read them, they were fine, don't want them. Everything by Nicola Yoon, I hated this so much, it was so terrible. The big plot twist, I could tell you from page 3. Like, it was just not good. No, I didn't like it. I really don't understand the hype around it. The concept was so cool, and then it got ruined. This is about a girl who's allergic to everything. Like, it's just, it's dumb. It's literally so dumb. Next, we got An Abundance of Catherines by John Green. I just didn't really vibe with this book. I remember not really liking it when I read it the first time. A lot of it revolves around math. I don't really like math. From what I remember of this book, there's this guy, and he has a thing for a girl named Catherines, and he's dated like 19 people named Catherine, and yeah, nothing was memorable about this. So next, we got the last three books in the Beautiful Creatures series. I'm not unhauling the first one because I recently reread the first one. I really liked it. These are not bad. I just don't really want them on my shelf anymore. The first one I honestly think could stand alone. It takes place in this southern town in like North Carolina, I think. This town is like obsessed with the Civil War. The kid named Ethan, who ends up meeting this girl named Lena, but she has powers, and everyone in her family, when they turn 16, either gets claimed by light magic or dark magic. It's just good. I don't know. I like it. The movie's really good. I know people think the movie's bad. I don't. I really enjoy the movie. I just don't really need the last three. I obviously am keeping the first one. It's on my shelf over there. I think the first one can stand alone, especially because there weren't other movies made. So I'm keeping the first one, and we're getting rid of these. Next, I got Popular by Maya Van Wagenen. I can never pronounce her name. This book is a true story that this girl, Maya, this is her right here. She wrote when she was like 15 or 16. She finds this book on popularity that was written in the 1950s. Through reading this book, she learns how to be popular and become more confident. I don't know, it's a good story for younger girls to read. I did read this when I was young. I read it when it first came out, which was probably around 2012. Oh, I was wrong. 2015. I read this in 2015. I liked it at the time. It's just not something I'm ever gonna reread. I think it's a really, really interesting book. I remember everyone being like, because like a teenager wrote it and published it, and that just like really doesn't happen. It's just not something I really needed to keep on my shelf because I'm not gonna reread it again. We're almost at the end, I promise. Next, I'm unhauling Fifth Wave series by Rick Yancey. If you're wondering where the third one is, I am also wondering where the third one is. I don't know where it is. When I find it, it'll get unhauled as well, but right now I only have the first two. I loved the first book when I first read it. I don't know what I rated it, but I thought it was amazing. And then I read the second one and it was bad, and then I read the third heard one of them was bad, and I was like, well, yeah, no, no thank you. I might keep just the first one because I really did like this book, but I definitely don't want this one, and I definitely don't want the third one. In this series, I think like 96% of the world's population gets wiped out. Aliens came and like killed the people. Now all these aliens are like coming down and they're like infiltrating people's bodies. And I don't know, it was cool. The concept is cool. The first book is really good. The last two are not. Oh, the tea is hot with these last four. I kind of just gave it away, but Divergent. Do you get it? I gave it away because I said four. Ha ha ha. They are such a copy of The Hunger Games, and I never understood why people said that, and now I do. I was actually planning on rereading Divergent and seeing how bad it was, but then I remembered that the second book was trash, and this one was just absolute garbage and made no sense, and I was like, why would I put myself reading through them again? I just don't understand. Yeah, it's a shame these books got so bad. I don't think I need to tell you the plot of these. It's just another dystopian society, except for this one's in Chicago. And it gets really bad at the end and it's gross. Okay, so those are the 38, I think, books that I'm gonna be unhauling. Don't know what I'm doing with them yet. When I figure it out, I'll let you know. Since I unhauled so many books and I'm still in the process of rearranging my bookshelf, I'm gonna be doing a bookshelf tour once I'm done fixing it. It's kind of a little messy right now. Subscribe if you were entertained throughout this video. Give it a like. All right. That's kind of it for me today. My name's Sara. Good night.